Ayurveda, the knowledge of life and longevity, is perhaps the oldest existing body of knowledge on the healing process. This holistic and natural healing system was developed by highly evolved spiritual beings who not only addressed the body and mind, but also the human spirit and consciousness. This knowledge system, which is in perfect harmony with the Indian thought process, and the origin of which can be traced to the Vedas, does not aim at mere cure of the disease syndrome. Instead, it looks to harmonize the living body and restore it to its natural state of equilibrium. Ayurveda goes far beyond being a mere system of medicine. It is a way of life propounded specifically for the upliftment of mankind. The original Ayurveda treatises give a comprehensive description of how to live one's life in tune with nature, free of disease. Ayurveda gives a graphic account of how the living body is only a microcosm of the macrocosm that is nature, and all elements that exist in the latter are reflected in the living body also. This close interaction with nature forms the basis for the indigenous thought process, and in Ayurveda too, this is the foundation on which all the theories, principles, classifications, categories, etc. are built. Ayurveda teaches that health is maintained by the balance of the three functional mechanisms known as Vata, Pitta and Kapha. All Ayurveda treatments are designed to return these units to a harmonious balance rather than treat what their imbalance manifests. Thus, it focuses on causes rather than symptoms. Since each individual has his own particular blend or balance, Ayurveda treats the individual and not the disease. Such an approach has proved to be highly effective through the centuries, and consequently, many Ayurveda healing regimens have been adopted and refined by people all over the world. In this presentation, we are going to view some of these healing regimens as explained by Ayurveda. Among the different treatments, two groups of treatments deserve special attention. The first is the group of treatments known as Panchakarma, which include five techniques, namely Vamana or emesis, Virechana or purgation, Asthapana Vasti or decoction enema, Anuvasana Vasti or oil enema, and Nasya or nasal therapy. These treatments are primarily applied to remove the excessive toxins accumulated in the body over a period of time, leading to the formation of various disease conditions. The second group of treatments are conveniently termed as the Kerala treatments. Kerala is a tiny state in the southernmost tip of India. Ayurveda has flourished in this region over the years, and the physicians of this region have contributed greatly to the sustenance, growth and development of Ayurveda. Based on the classical principles of Ayurveda, they have improvised and developed treatment methods which are not as complicated or dangerous as the Panchakarma and yet are nearly as effective. Some of these treatments are Shilhara or pouring oil on the forehead or head, Pirichal or squeezing oil onto the body of the patient, Navrakiri or inducing sudation by use of boluses containing medicated rice pudding, and Talam or Shirolepa or applying a medicated paste to the head. All these treatments, whether the Panchakarmas or the Kerala treatments, have the following general rules. The first is three stages of treatment, namely the preparatory phase, during which Abhyanga or simple oil application is done and the physician closely observes the patient. The main treatment phase, when any of the above treatments are applied based on medical need. And the post-treatment recuperative phase, when Abhyanga is again done or some other simple treatments are done based on medical need. Here, the patient is under total rest and slowly regains his or her strength. All the three karmas or stages form equally important parts of the Panchakarma and the Kerala treatments, and hence the treatment will not really benefit the patient without the proper and strict implementation of all the three stages. Thus, the texts say, just as a small spark being fed gradually with hay, dry cow dung cakes, etc., assumes a huge shape, becomes steady and capable of burning away anything, so also the digestive fire of the person who has undergone the purificatory therapies is gradually built up by a regimen of strict diet or payadi karma. This shows the importance of the after-treatment procedures to be followed strictly. This regimen is the same generally for all therapies and also for all those who are afflicted with disease. It is interesting to note that the texts insist that this regimen is even applicable for all those who take the treatment. This means that even healthy people who take these treatments as a rejuvenative measure are bound by these strictures. Thus, a course of treatment would invariably be for a minimum of 21 days and can stretch to even 4 to 6 months based on the condition of the patient and the type of treatment that is being administered. With this introduction, we will now move on to study the following treatments: Abhyanga, Swedana, Vamana, Dhara and Purchil, Asthapana Vasti, Shirovasti and Navarakri. Abhyanga is one of the most widely and effectively used Ayurvedic external oil therapies. The primary accessories used include the medicated oil, which in this case is Dhanvantaram Tailam for the body and Kshirabala Tailam for the head, loin cloth, which is to be worn around the waist, towels and green gram powder to be used for bathing the patient after treatment. The oil for the body is heated and kept ready. The process of Abhyanga commences with a prayer to Lord Dhanvantari, the god of healing. Then the therapist takes the oil for the head and applies it on the head of the patient. After that, a little oil is applied in both the ears, and then applied on the face of the patient. Please note that absolutely no pressure is used during this treatment, and the therapist works with extremely soft hands. Oil should be applied especially to the head, the ears and the feet. On the head, it is good for the hairs, the skull and the sensory organs. Inside the ears, it relieves the pain of the lower jaw, neck, head and ears. Applied to the soles of the feet, it makes them strong, promotes further coarseness, stiffness, roughness, fatigue and numbness of feet are alleviated in no time. It also prevents occurrence of sciatica, cracking of soles and constriction of veins and ligaments.
Bhasha Patipata Divasara Suddhimarat शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् ईषत् प्रफुल्ल सरसीरुहनारिकेर पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोघर पालिकानाम् आवाति मन्दमनिलः सह दिव्य गन्धैः.
After applying oil on the face, oil is applied to the feet. Abhyanga is normally done in 7 positions, namely sitting, lying on the back, lying on the right side, lying on the back, lying on the left side, lying on the back, and finally in the sitting position. Thus, the therapist commences the process of Abhyanga on the body with the patient in the sitting position. In this position, the therapist primarily focuses on the upper part of the body, including the region of the chest and abdomen, both the hands, the upper and lower back, and the region of the neck. Then the patient is made to lie down, and after he is comfortable, the process of oil application on the body commences. For the sake of convenience, the therapist divides his area of work into 4 parts: the left upper torso, the left lower limb, the right upper torso, and the right lower limb. And he works systematically in each of these areas, taking care to ensure that no part of the body is left untouched. He moves his hands primarily in the downward direction so that the flow of vata is not disturbed. In any intensive Ayurveda treatment, Abhyanga plays an important role in the preparatory and post-purificatory stages of the treatment. The texts say that he who administers the purificatory therapies without making the body soft by doing snehana or uliation therapy and swedana or sudation therapy will be just like a person who tries to bend a dry piece of wood. The body will be destroyed completely thereby.
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् मीनाकृते कमठकोल नृसिंहवर्णिम् स्वामिन् परश्वत तपोधन रामचन्द्र.
नाउ द पेशेंट इज टर्न्ड ओवर सो एज टू लाई ऑन हिज राइट साइड एंड आफ्टर इंश्योरिंग that he is comfortable, the therapist begins to work on the back of the patient. The patient is generally not made to turn over completely and lie on his stomach as it will affect his digestive process. Abhyanga quells vata, promotes strength, sleep, growth and firmness of hair, is useful to subside pains, tiredness and debility, similar to the axle of the chariot becoming durable by applying oil. Rubbing oil all over the body alleviates foul smell, heaviness, drowsiness and itching. The body of one who does oil application regularly does not become affected much, even if subjected to accidental injuries or strenuous work. Now, the patient returns to lying on his back and the oil application continues. As is quite apparent, Abhyanga is hardly a massage, for there is very little pressure that is used during this treatment. The effect is also not immediate, for it is hardly sensual or appealing to the sense organs. Now, the patient moves into the fifth position, which is the left side. Thus, the emphasis in this treatment is on the medicated oil that is used in the treatment rather than on the actual act of massage. In fact, there is absolutely no massage involved, and the therapist is primarily concerned with initially applying the warm medicated oil all over the patient's body and then with rubbing this oil gently into the patient's body. Now, the patient returns to lying on his back and the oil application continues. It is interesting to note that Vayu is predominant in the tactile sense organ, which again is located in the skin. Oil application is the most beneficial for the skin, hence one should do it regularly. Finally, the patient is brought to the seventh position, namely the sitting position. Oil application should be avoided by those suffering from diseases of kapha origin and those having indigestion. Thus, it may be noticed that the treatment follows a particular order and is symmetrically done. However, when the treatment is done by very experienced therapists, their touch, which has been sharpened by experience and intuition, will take its own course based on their understanding of the patient. Hence, they may not necessarily follow a particular order of treatment. Ayurveda says that Abhyanga should be done daily as it wards off old age, exertion and aggravation of Vata dosha, bestows good vision, nourishment of the body, long life, good sleep, good and healthy skin. It should be done specially to the head, the ears and the feet.
Hare Venkatesha Prasida Prasida Priyam Venkatesha Prayaccha Prayaccha Aham Duratatte Padam Bhoja Yugma Praname Chaya Gatya Sevam Karomi సకృత్సేవయా నిత్య సేవా ఫలం త్వం ప్రయచ్ఛ ప్రయచ్ఛ ప్రభో వెంకటేశ.
On completion of the treatment, the patient is given a bath using warm water for the body and lukewarm water for the head. A paste of green gram powder and water is used to remove the oil. This paste not only removes the oil, it is also very good for the texture and complexion of the skin.
పద్మాలంకృత పాణి పల్లవ యుగాం పద్మాసనస్థాం శ్రియం వాత్సల్యాది గుణోజ్వలాం భగవతీం వందే జగన్మాతరం. శ్రీమన్ కృపా జల నిధే కృత సర్వలోక సర్వజ్ఞ శక్తన తవత్సల సర్వశేషిన్ స్వామిన్ సుశీల సులభాశ్రుత పారిజాత శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. శ్రీమన్ కృపా జల నిధే కృత సర్వలోక సర్వజ్ఞ శక్తన తవత్సల సర్వశేషిన్ స్వామిన్ సుశీల సులభాశ్రుత పారిజాత శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. ఆనూపురార్పిత సుజాత సుగంధి పుష్ప సౌరభ్య సౌరభకరౌ సమసన్నివేశౌ సౌమ్యౌ సదానుభవనేపి నవానుభావ్యౌ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. సద్యోవికాది సముదిత్వర సాంద్ర రాగ సౌరభ్య నిర్భర సరోరుక సామ్య వార్తాం సమ్యక్షు సాహస పదేషు విలేఖయంతౌ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. రేఖామయధ్వజ సుదాకల శాత పద్ర వజ్రాంకుశాంబురుగ కల్పక శంఖ చక్రైః భవ్యైరలంకృత తలౌ పర తత్వ చిహ్నైః శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. తామ్రోదరద్విది పరాజిత పద్మరాగౌ బాహ్యైర్మహోభిరభిభూత మహేంద్ర నీలౌ ఉద్యన్న కాలు బిరుదస్త శశాంక భాసౌ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. సప్రేమ భీతి కమలాకర పల్లవాభ్యాం సంవాహనేపి సపదిక్రమమాదధానౌ కాంతావవాంగ్మన సగోచర సౌకుమార్యౌ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ చరణౌ శరణం ప్రపద్యే. లక్ష్మీమహీతదనురూప నిజాంభావనీరాది దివ్యమహిషీకర పల్లవానాం ఆరుణ్య సంక్రమణ తక్కిల సాంద్ర.
Now the therapist dries the patient using the towels. Then he applies a herbal powder, Rasnadi Churnam in this case, to the head of the patient, after which the patient also inhales the powder. This is done to prevent the accumulation of kapha. Finally, the patient is advised to take rest for at least an hour after not only Abhyanga but every Ayurveda treatment. Charaka, the great Ayurveda teacher, says, Stambha Gaurava Sheetagnam Svedanam Svedakarakam. The process which relieves Stambha or stiffness, Gaurava or heaviness, Sheeta or coldness, and which induces sweating is known as Svedana or sudation therapy. The effects of sudation therapy are: improves the digestive fire, limbs become soft, the skin becomes smooth, increases the appetite and taste, the channels will be cleared, absence of drowsiness, and restores the functions of the joints. Thus, by sudation, the vitiated doshas are brought back to the alimentary canal, from where they can be eliminated by the various panchakarma or purificatory procedures. There are several different ways by which svedana can be induced. Here we are going to demonstrate bashpa svedana, which is normally administered to the patient after snehapana treatment, which is the drinking of medicated clarified butter or ghee. This treatment is done for a duration of 30 to 60 minutes or till sweating is induced. First, the medicated water to be used generates steam during the treatment is prepared using the leaves of the following drugs, the properties of which are normally guru or heavy, tikshna or penetrating, and ushna or hot. Sarshapa or Brassica campestris, Karanja or Pongamia glabra, Eranda or Ricinus communis, Datura or Datura metal, Arka or Calotropis gigantia, Shigru or Moringa olifera. All these ingredients are boiled together in water and kept ready. Then a wooden cot is tied with cotton ropes and got ready for the treatment. A fresh banana leaf is placed on the cot and all the four sides of the cot are wrapped with cotton sheets. The patient is asked to lie down on the banana leaf. Then a cotton cloth is placed covering his heart and the groin region is also covered with a loin cloth. His eyes are also covered with cotton pads immersed in rose water and tied with a piece of cloth. This is because the heart, the eyes and the groins should never be exposed to direct heat as it is extremely harmful. Then the patient is covered with a banana leaf and followed by a cotton sheet and later a thick woolen blanket. The head is left uncovered. Now he is subjected to heat using two vessels containing the boiled medicated water, one placed below the legs and the other placed below the region of the back. To ensure continuous exposure to steam, the water is reheated and replaced and the process is repeated several times. Slowly, the patient begins to sweat. Then the position is changed and the patient is asked to turn over and lie on his abdomen with the chin supported by a cotton towel. Then he is asked to lie first on his right side and then on his left side. After proper sweating has been induced all over the body, thus the woolen blanket is removed. Then the patient continues to lie for some more time till the sweat has completely dried. Then his body is wiped with a dry towel and oil is applied, and this is followed by a bath. This treatment is extremely effective to enable the accumulation of the doshas in the region of the abdomen, from where they are expelled using the appropriate panchakarma procedures. Generally, svedana is indicated in conditions like dyspnea, cough, hiccup, heaviness, headache, earache, pain in the neck, paralysis, constipation, rigidity of the sides of the chest, back and waist, sciatica, stiffness and loss of sensation. Charaka defines Vamana as Tatra Doshaharanam Urdhva Bhagam Vamana Sabnyakam, that which eliminates the impurities from the upper part of the body is known as Vamana. Vamana or emesis is the first in the series of treatments aimed at removing the vitiated doshas from the system. As we are all aware, kapha is the dosha that occurs first in anything to do with the living body. In childhood, kapha is the most prominent dosha and is primarily associated with the building up or constructive process or growth that takes place. In the course of a day, kapha is predominant with the beginning of sunrise and the beginning of sunset. During the digestive process, kapha is predominant in the first stage of digestion. And if we look at the erect human being, kapha is prominent in the upper part of the body, that is, the space above the chest region. When this kapha is vitiated, the most important treatment that can be given is the emetic process, which will enable the vitiated kapha to be thrown out of the system. In fact, Vamana is not aimed only at dispelling the vitiated kapha. It also enables correction in conditions where pitta occupies the place of kapha or in a vata predominant kapha state. The medicines used for the Vamana we are about to show you are 3.5 grams vacha or Acorus calamus and Yeshti Madhu or Glycyrrhiza glabra, Madanaphala or Randia dumatorum 7 grams, 2 grams of Saindhava or rock salt and 1/2 gram of rock camphor. All of the above are together made into a paste with honey. The patient should be first made ready for the treatment by giving him the oleation and sudation therapies which were described earlier. Preferably, the patient should be given a course of snehapana or intake of medicated ghee or clarified butter for a period of 7 days, commencing with a small dose and then gradually building up till the 7th day, by which time the body will be suitably unctured. On the 8th day, the patient is given the prescribed sudation therapy. Then, the night previous to the administration of the Vamana, the patient should be given milk or curds or eatables prepared with black gram, sesame, oil cakes or green vegetables added with large quantities of water. This is given to excite and increase the kapha in the body. The next morning, when the food of the previous day is found to have been well digested, the patient, having offered his prayers, should be asked to sit facing east comfortably on a chair. He should not have taken any food. Then, milk should be given to drink in sufficient quantity till the patient is full right up to the throat. Normally, a liter of fluid is given, which may even go up to a couple of liters depending on the individual patient. Then, the drug to produce vomiting should be given to him, made warm and mixed with honey and rock salt. If required, more milk can be given till the urge for vomiting arises. When the urge to vomit arises, the attendants should hold the patient's flanks and forehead firmly and give mild massage in the upward direction over the back and calm the patient. The patient should keep open his lips, palate and throat, and when the vomiting has commenced, the patient should bend just sufficiently to bring out the material. The bouts of vomiting should be allowed to continue either till the kapha is expelled out or the medicine administered comes out or till the pitta comes out based on the assessment by the physician. If the vomiting is inadequate, the bouts should be induced further by drinking warm water containing a paste of pepper, mustard, salt, etc. The quantity of vomited material collected in the receiving vessel each time should be noted. Generally, emesis occurs till the appearance of pitta in the vomiters or the elimination of the entire kapha. Pitta can be known as a brownish yellow sticky material. The person who has had vamana adequately should wash his hands, feet and mouth, take comfortable rest for about half an hour and then take an inhalation of medicated smoke according to his capacity, wash once again with water and sleep on a cot inside a room devoid of heavy breeze. Then, taking note of his digestive capacity and appearance of hunger, either in the evening of the same day or the next day, he should take bath in comfortable warm water and take food prepared from old red rice, boiled well, without mixing it with ghee, salt and pungents, or mixed with very little quantity of these substances, liquid in consistency, and followed by drinking of warm water both in the afternoons and mornings. He should also adhere strictly to the regimen of taking liquid foods twice a day for 8 days, 5 days or 3 days respectively based upon the extent of vomiting that he has had. The principle is that he will move slowly from very thin gruel on the first day to very thick gruel by the last day. The symptoms of properly done emesis therapy are the proper expulsion of kapha, pitta and vata in succeeding order at the proper time, quantity of the vomited material not being very large, coming out without much discomfort, bouts coming up and subsiding of their own accord, clarity of mind, purity of the voice, and absence of symptoms like loss of appetite. As is told, for every treatment, the diet and lifestyle restrictions are to be strictly followed for the prescribed duration after the treatment in order to get the maximum benefit. Vamana treatment is indicated in conditions of poisoning, indigestion, acute fever, tuberculosis, diarrhea, insanity, epilepsy, bronchitis, asthma, diabetes, skin diseases, anemia, obesity, rhinitis, tonsillitis, etc. Shirodhara and Purichal are two specialized treatments that have been developed by the physicians of Kerala based on the classical Ayurveda dictates. They are specifically based on the treatment called Seka, which is the pouring of medicated fluid. Here, we are about to view a treatment session where both these treatments are done together, due to which six therapists work simultaneously on the patient. Shirodhara is the treatment where medicated fluid is poured on the head of the patient continuously for a period ranging from 45 to 90 minutes based on need. Purichal is a modified process of Kaya Seka, which requires the use of a lesser quantity of oil as compared to Kaya Seka. The name Purichal is a Malayalam word meaning to squeeze, and the process is literally the squeezing of pieces of cloth soaked in medicated oil onto the body of the patient. This therapy is normally given continuously for a minimum period of 7 to 14 days for about 60 to 90 minutes every day. Before commencing the treatment, a prayer is offered to Lord Dhanvantari, the God of healing. Then, medicated oil is first applied to the head. Here, the oil used is Kshirabala Tailam. Then, the oil is applied to the ears and the face of the patient.
Atreya Sushruta Munit Charakagnivesha Dakshashvineya Surarat Pramukhascha Vaidya.
After applying the oil, a long cotton cloth is comfortably tied around the forehead of the patient. This is tied only when Shirodhara is done, and its purpose is to prevent the flow of oil into the eyes of the patient. Next, oil is applied all over the body of the patient. The oil that is used for the body in this case is Prabhanjanam Tailam. After applying the oil, Purichal is commenced in the sitting position. As in Abhyanga, Purichal is also normally done in seven positions. Namely, sitting, lying on the back, lying on the right side, lying on the back, lying on the left side, lying on the back, and finally again in the sitting position. However, when Purichal and Shirodhara are done together, the treatment is done only in three positions, namely sitting, lying on the back and again in the sitting position. Now, after the patient is made to lie, the therapists take their seats on either side of the patient. The body of the patient is divided into four parts, namely the left upper torso, the left lower limb, the right upper torso, and the right lower limb. Each therapist works specifically on the particular part of the body assigned to him. The oil is continually heated and then the cloth is dipped in the oil and squeezed onto the body of the patient, after which the other hand moves gently, rubbing the oil into the body of the patient. The oil is again heated and the process continues. This cycle is kept going for the entire duration of the treatment.
Deva pradakshina parastava mandirasya dhanvantare sapadi jagrihi suprabhatam dhanvantare sapadi jagrihi suprabhatam. Samrakshanaay jagatat parivardhanaay dharmasya rogaharanaay nijashritana.
In case spiritual is being done alone, then every 10 minutes the patient changes position and the treatment is done. Around 2.5 liters of oil is used every day for this treatment. Spiritual is useful in all types of vata disorders and particularly arthritis and paralysis. It is also good for healthy persons to undergo this treatment annually to prevent diseases and also to slow down the aging process. It can be prescribed for the patient either as a preparatory treatment for the panchakarma like vasti, or it can be done as a standalone treatment, for by itself it is extremely effective in different disorders of vata aggravation. These days spiritual is commonly prescribed as a standalone treatment and normally has the following phases: an initial preparatory phase where abhyanga is done for 5 to 7 days, the main treatment phase where purichal is done for 7 to 21 days based on need, and the post-treatment recuperative phase where again abhyanga is done for an equal number of days. Thus, the average duration of treatment is around 5 weeks, and during this process the patient is advised to take total rest and also follow a very strict diet. Ideally, the patient should be admitted as an inpatient to ensure that he gets maximum benefit and also to enable the physicians to monitor his condition regularly. Doing the treatment for shorter durations without paying any attention to the restrictions can be harmful, as this is a very intensive treatment and needs to be performed with utmost care. Moving on to Shirodhara. Shirodhara is especially useful to strengthen and stabilize the body and mind, improve the perception of taste for food, improve the memory, voice, skin, eyes and sleep, nourish the shukra and rakta dhatus, increase interest in coitus and slow down the aging process. Shirodhara can be done using either medicated oil, buttermilk or medicated milk depending on the condition of the patient. Lukewarm dhara drava or medicated fluid is poured into the earthen pot which is hanging above the patient's head and the flow of which is controlled by a bunch of thread passing through a coconut shell placed inside the earthen pot. This pot, it is continually oscillated over the forehead in a mildly circular fashion so that the dhara drava does not fall continually at any particular point on the forehead and the patient does not feel any discomfort. Around 2 liters of dhara drava is used every day for this treatment. When shirodhara is done alone without being accompanied by purichil, there will be only 3 therapists working on the patient. 2 will be involved in the shirodhara while the third will do abhyanga on the body of the patient. Though this treatment is commonly referred to as the third eye treatment, it may be noted that the fluid does not actually fall on the third eye. Further, the dhara pot is continually rotated in a mildly circular fashion to ensure that excessive pressure is not created at any one point. For this is again a very intensive treatment which can be as strenuous as the panchakarmas and hence needs to be performed with utmost care. As mentioned for purichil, this treatment too is performed as both a preparatory treatment for the purificatory therapies as well as a standalone treatment. Whatever may be the case, all the diet and lifestyle restrictions are to be strictly adhered to and the treatment too must be performed for the minimum duration prescribed to ensure that it is not only effective but also does not cause any side effects. When the prescribed duration for the treatment is over, the dhara pot is moved back slowly and the cloth piece around the head is removed and the oil wiped off from the forehead, the head and the face. Then the patient is brought back to the sitting position and the treatment continues. At the end of the treatment, the patient is given a bath as explained earlier during Abhyanga. After that, the patient is taken to his room where he is asked to lie down for at least an hour, after which he can take some light food. At the end of the full course of treatment, there is a small ritual called the Pati Puja. Here, the Dhara Droni is first cleaned well and then some offerings are made to the Dhara Droni, and coconut water, which is cooling, is poured onto it. Finally, a thanksgiving prayer is also offered.